Hi everyone, I'm Brian with the Scientist in Every Florida School program, and in this edition of Science Segments, I'm excited to connect you with a scientist to help you learn about environmental policy. Who are you and what is your title?
I'm Alex Fiak and I'm a PhD student at the University of Florida.
What do you research and why is that important?
I research community ecology of seagrasses, and it's important because it helps us understand how seagrasses interact with other plants and animals, and that can help us understand the best ways to preserve this important group of plants. Seagrasses are important marine plants because they buffer wave action and they can provide habitat for lots of other organisms, including juvenile fish, and they also help to improve water quality.
Can you please briefly discuss the need for monitoring of environmental parameters when making policy decisions?
Sure. So environmental monitoring is helpful for a couple of reasons. It can help you to identify problems. For example, if you have reason to suspect there's an environmental problem, monitoring can help you identify the scope and severity of the problem. For example, in a creek in a residential area where people, maybe their children like to play and swim in, if it happens to be next to a dog park, you might have a lot of runoff of dog waste, and that's a potential health hazard. So a local municipality might want to monitor for things like fecal coliform and bacteria levels in the creek. And then that can inform policy decisions to maybe post signage to protect people, telling them there are hazardous amounts of bacteria in the creek, or maybe they want to increase fines for not picking up after your dog at the park. Another reason to monitor would be to evaluate the effectiveness of current policy. You want to know how well is a current rule or policy achieving its goals. Something I've experienced in is water quality monitoring at the national level for the Environmental Protection Agency. They want to monitor at a really large scale to see how the Clean Water Act, which is intended to make most waters fishable and swimmable for the public, how well our efforts as a country to implement this policy have been going. So we regularly monitored all sorts of water bodies, lakes, rivers and streams, wetlands, as well as coastal waters to get a big picture of how water quality is improving, declining. And one example of a state government using that information, that data to implement policy was our findings that vegetation lining streams buffered them and helped filter pollutants before they entered the stream, and then generally led to better water quality in those streams. So then the state of Minnesota incorporated this into their policy, encouraging landowners to maintain those little buffers of vegetation along streams.
Thank you, Alex, and thank you all so much for watching. We will see you next time.